And my challenge was to produce a gold standard for what might be expected outcomes for a group of patients who might fit a laparoscopic selection criteria. Now, I've been resecting colorectal mets for 22 years, and for most of that time was very confused, because for every criteria that you see there, I could produce you a paper that showed that it improved survival and another paper that showed it made survival worse. So for a very long time, we really had no idea what was going on. And then a couple of years ago, a group of us got together and we actually reviewed all those papers, believe it or not. It was a big task. But to our disappointment, out of 529 papers, only 30 were eligible for review. In other words, they had more than 100 patients included, that there were clarity of the data, and so on. And as I've reviewed all the papers for laparoscopic resections of colorectal, the same applies, I'm afraid. They're all small numbers, it's not quite clear. So today, we're just going to hopefully set a standard for what you should expect. Now, from all that data, all the big series in the world, including the Sloan Kettering and ours, we all agree what are the factors that affect survival and what factors are not significant, including, very importantly, bilobar disease. Well, I haven't got the time to go into all of that today. So we looked at our liver resection experience, and of the colorectal metastases, we had 1,295. We excluded four palliative, 137 redos, just to keep it clear, and two people had their primary op elsewhere. Never mind. The total group, therefore, is 1,152. Now, which resections should we include? With the exception of Brees, all the other committee were agreed as to what operations should be included and what should be excluded. And we included patients who obviously had segments 2, 3, right hepatectomy, left hepatectomy, any of the segments 5, 6, or 4B, or any combinations of that group. The previous slide was the opposite of that, which is the extended procedures, which somehow came out of order, but just assume that that was a group that was much more technically challenging. So when we looked at the data, we excluded about 50% just on the type of operations. In other words, extensive resections, complex bilateral procedures were in the excluded group. We then took as a maximum size of 6 centimeters. We actually did the analysis with 8 centimeters, and I can tell you there was no difference in the conclusions I will give you. But for clarity, we'll stick with just the 6 centimeters. So if we limit it for size, we're left with 370. We lost a few more by exclusion of tumors that involved the hilum, the cava, or the veins. And with due respect, Brees, they are actually technically difficult no matter how you're going to do them. So we thought we'd be clearer to leave them out.